In the past 2 weeks, an app called Bionic Reading raised a lot of attention, but the explanations both by journalists and by the creators of the app regarding what the app is doing and, most importantly, how it's doing it are kind of questionable. My name is Peter Vito, and I've been studying human perception for 15 years, and although I'm not a reading researcher per se, my topics like eye movements and object perception relate to here quite closely, so I'll give an attempt to probably better dissect the mechanisms behind what's going on here. So this is the app. Basically, it's setting the beginning of each word in bold, and the rest remains in normal font, and you can change yourself how much of the word you want to be in bold, and many people love it. They say that they read faster with it, and of course the creators also claim that you can read faster, but not only that, but also that you can comprehend the text more in depth, and also that dyslexics are going to benefit from this app. So this is their website, proudly supported by the World Economic Forum. Actually, the creator of the app claims not to have taken any investor money. I don't really know how that works, but that's above my pay grade. And this is the title that you saw everywhere. If you read any articles on this, that your brain reads faster than your eye. Whatever that means, again, but okay, maybe this is just to grab attention. And they also say that the reader is only focusing on the highlighted initial letters and lets the brain center, whatever that means, complete the word. And elsewhere they say that our brains can identify whole words from just a few letters. And online, several people have seemed to take this literally. And they were asking like, okay, I don't get it. How does my brain know that the word is new when it only sees N? Obviously, this is not how it works. The not bold part of the word is also processed. How does it work? What do we do when we read? Our eyes make two basic types of movements. One is called a fixation, where it stays in a small area. It still moves, but it basically stays in the same place. And then it makes a very quick movement to the next fixation location. And this quick movement is called a saccade. And then comes the next saccade, etc. So what you see here is that there are fewer, and this is a common way to depict it. So here the circle size just shows the temporal duration, so the how long each fixation was. And you can see that there are basically fewer circles than words. So they also claim, the app creators, that when you read normally, your eyes scan the whole word. If they are speaking about eye movements, this is not true. But indeed, there is a location where the eyes like to fall on the word, and this can be measured on average, say, for a certain population, but also for a certain individual, because there's an individual variance in this. And when you know that, you can present each word aligned to that preferred location. And this is called RSVP, Rapid Serial Visual Presentation. This has existed for many decades, and this is indeed theoretically, and I think also practically, the fastest way we can read, because we don't even have to move our eyes, right? And alongside this, there have also been many methods to speed up our reading. So why don't we use these methods all the time? I'll get back to that later. But first, let's look at some other mechanisms through which this app can be helpful. So these eye movements and the preferred locations, of course, in the context of reading, are driven by the words, by the text primarily. But they are also driven by saliency, which is basically how attention-grabbing something is. And part of it is low-level saliency. In this case, that's the contrast between the black of the font and the white background. And if you just look at this edge, of course the contrast is the same for the bold and for the normal font. But when you filter this whole thing with a certain spatial frequency, then indeed the bold is going to be more salient. I don't have to go into detail as for how that actually works, but so the bold is going to be more salient, driving the eyes more to the beginning of the word. So this can indeed be very useful and helpful to identify the beginning of the word and automatically help with the fixations, as the app creators also call these bold parts of the word fixation points. And another side of this is high-level perception, or high-level saliency, based on objects. So if you have a very long word, having the first part of it in bold creates its own object on one level. And then on another level, of course, the whole word still stays one object. That's how you read it. But so that, again, drives the eyes, helps the eyes find the beginning of the word. So this can be useful, making it easier for the eyes to read. And one more way it can be useful can be understood if we first look at horizontal autocorrelation in words. So when you have a word like this, there's a lot of square, straight, vertical lines, right? And we've seen that the eyes move a lot very quickly horizontally while we read. And during these movements, the retinal image moves very quickly, so it's just a smear. And therefore, generally, it is suppressed. But it's not suppressed completely. And the information, also from the smear, is used through the saccade to determine where the saccadic eye movement has to land for the next fixation location, ideally right on the target. But when stimuli like this appear, these lines, as you move horizontally, these vertical lines overlap with each other. Basically, they look identical, and at different distances, they overlap a lot. And we can put a number to this, and that is called autocorrelation. And the higher that is, basically, the more confusing it seems to the eyes. Because, of course, so the eyes don't know which line is which, basically. And therefore, the saccade is going to be less precise, and oftentimes it doesn't land where it should have landed, so another saccade needs to be made so that it actually ends up on the target location. And this problem is even bigger on flickering displays, because when you see a flickering stimulus, here there's a lamp which flickers and is just moved across the visual field, which is the same thing basically as when the lamp is stationary and you move your eyes horizontally, right? So the flickering stimulus, it goes on and off very quickly. It creates the same type of repetitive patterns. And flickering displays also do that, and through that slow down our reading and increase the effort that we have to make for the same reading performance. And of course, such an image called a phantom array or beads effect is very similar to the fonts themselves. So the two type of repetitions will interfere with each other, further creating confusion and further making saccades less precise. So what this bold font is doing is that the autocorrelation will be lower. You see the overlap, the chances of confusing one line with the other are lower. So indeed, that might also help our eye movements. Okay, so these have all been very positive things, but some people also comment negatively, saying that they can read slower with the app, it takes more effort for them, it's confusing. And many of them online, interestingly, highlighted that they are not native speakers of English. And this might indeed be of significance, because in English, generally the strategy called sight word reading is beneficial. So this is when you just gaze quickly at the word and grasp the whole word at once. But in agglutinative languages, like Japanese, Turkish, or Hungarian, in this instance, there's a larger emphasis on the ends of the words. And also, there's a lot of research showing that in these languages, an instruction which is phonic, so it emphasizes letter by letter reading, is more beneficial. And indeed, there have also been attempts to adopt to these languages the Anglo-Saxon methods for sight word reading, and they have failed miserably. They have created more dyslexic people. So this is not to be taken lightly, especially today with all the online education and children reading from displays, and these issues, both with dyslexia and ADHD, being more prevalent, increasing the prevalence of dyslexia through forcing sightword reading, even implicitly, like with this app, onto people for whom a letter-by-letter reading strategy, at the very least at the beginning of their learning to read, holds some dangers. And this leads back to the question, okay, why don't we try everything to read faster? Of course, it would be better to read faster, right? Well, this has also been studied for many decades, and it's really clear. This is just one example paper where they stated right in the middle of the abstract that there is a trade-off between speed and accuracy. So you can speed up your reading, but usually your comprehension is going to suffer. And the way to maintain high comprehension and get through text faster is to practice reading. Like, there are no cheap and quick shortcuts, duh. But this app claims to both speed up your reading and facilitate more in-depth understanding of the text. And most disturbingly, they also claim that it helps people with dyslexia. And again, there's a lot of research on people who are dyslexic or have ADHD showing that it's exactly the opposite which helps them. It's slowing down their reading, which is going to help with their problems. So again, what is the goal here? These three claims seem to be contradictory and probably not properly explained, but let me know where I am wrong.